going on, guys? I'm your boy here, and today I'm bringing you guys another Division 2 build video. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you guys this build. This is a hybrid DPS build where we're using an assault rifle and a SMG for our main weapons for this build. And these weapons are going to be outputting the most damage with this build as well. So hope you guys enjoy. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and let's get into the build. So with this build, firstly, we're using the Exotic Backpack and Memento. This will be helping us get, you know, armor generation and also bonus armor, also giving us extra, you know, damage as well with this build. And with this build, we're sitting at 147% created damage with the assault rifle and 162% with the SMG. And also, we're sitting at 1.1 million armor. So this is, once again, a DPS build. So we're not too focused into being tanky with this build. And yeah, that's basically it for the stats. Now, we can first start off with the weapons. Let's first start off with the assault rifle. Using the G36C assault rifle. Basically maxed out stats. And it also has the attribute damage to target out of cover, which is multiplicative. And it also has a talent killer. Killing an enemy with a critical hit grants 40% created damage for 10 seconds. That's of course just helping us output even more damage with this weapon, and just helping us, you know, kill enemies much faster. Now, you can use whatever weapon in this slot. Like, I'm using an assault rifle and an SMG for this build for the hybrid setup, but you can use whatever you really want. I'm using G36C because I don't usually use it much. Not just that, I don't see it used much. I think it's pretty underrated actually, because it does a lot of damage with this build. So yeah, I feel like, you know, most weapons are pretty good in this game if you have the right build for it. So yeah, now we go over to my other weapon. I am using the tactical UMP45 SMG. Max style attributes, once again, has that attribute damage to target out of cover, which is multiplicative. And it also has a talent preservation. Killing an enemy repairs 10% armor over 5 seconds. Headshot kills improve the repair by an additional 10%. Now, I have preservation on here instead of something like killer, strained, or close and personal. So I can, because this is like a DPS build once again, so we don't have that much survivability. So I'm just trying to have as much sustainability, you know, being able to get armor back within a certain amount of time, having armor regen. So preservation is just going to be helping us get our armor back a bit faster. Also paired with the, you know, 3% armor regen with the Memento backpack. So yeah. And the way I have is modded, I have crit hit damage everywhere. So that's why it has more crit hit damage than the assault rifle. So yeah. Now we go down to my gear. Let's first off with the mask. Using one piece Gilligard for the 5% total armor. I'm using like Gilligard just to get me just a little bit over 1 million armor, but this is the only piece of armor that I have that's giving me armor. So yeah, now I'm just roll with crit hit chance and crit hit damage. And we have crit hit damage mods everywhere that could be mods, so it's the mask, the chest piece, and the backpack. Now we go down to the chest piece. Using two piece Soul Glock Concern for the 10% SMG damage and 15% crit hit damage. This is a roll with crit hit damage and crit hit chance, and it also has a talent obliterate. Critical hits increase total weapon damage by 1% for 5 seconds, stacking up 25 times. This of course is going to be helping us output more damage, and at maximum stats we're going to be getting 25% weapon damage. Now we go down to my holsters. Using one piece Seska for the 10% crit hit chance, and this roll crit hit chance and crit hit damage. Now we go over to my knee pads. This is our second piece of Soul Cloth Concern, which is giving us that 15% created damage. This roll will create a chance to create damage as well. And if we go up to our gloves now, using one piece Fender's Group for the 10% assault rifle damage, this roll will create damage and create a chance as well. And now if we go up to our backpack, once again, the exotic backpack, the Memento. If we look at the talent, it has kill confirmed. Enemies you kill drop a trophy on death. Collecting trophies provide both a short and long term buff. The first of which scales with the number of cards to be equipped and lasts 10 seconds. So for every red one, you're getting 5% weapon damage. For every blue one, you're getting 10% bonus armor. And for every yellow one, you're getting 5% skill efficiency. So with this build, I have five red core attributes. So we're gonna be getting 25% weapon damage every time we pick up a trophy. And you know, we only have two armor ones, so we're gonna be getting 20% bonus armor. And you know, we only have one, so we're just gonna be getting 5% skill efficiency every time we pick up a trophy as well. And also, for every trophy collected, you gain an additional 1% weapon damage, 1% skill efficiency, and 0.1% armor regeneration for 300 seconds, and that max out a stack of 30. So we're going to be getting 30% weapon damage, 30% skill efficiency, and 3% armor regeneration for those 300 seconds. And now we go down to the stats for this build. Well, not the stats, the skills for this build. Using the Striker Drone for this build as well. This is just helping distract the enemy so I don't get completely focused by all the enemies. And if we go over to my other skill I'm using. Using the Striker Ballistic Shield. This is the shield that you get from the Firewall Specialization tree. And this shield also gives you a damage bonus per enemy. So I'm at 12% because I have it also modded with two mods here. That's giving me extra damage bonus. So one's giving me 5% and one's giving me 1%. And that's it for the skills. Now we go over to the stats. So first off with the weapon stats, I'm doing 102,000 weapon damage with the G36C, 56% crit hit chance, also 147% crit hit damage. But remember, we have killer, so we're going to be getting 187% crit hit damage when we have killer active. And now we go over to our SMG stats. It's sitting at 148,000 weapon damage, 60% crit hit chance, and 162% crit hit damage. Now we go down to our armor. Once again, we're at 1.1 million armor. And we're going to be getting 3% armor regeneration when we're at maximum stacks with the memento. So, yeah, that's the build, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this was informative. Make sure you guys stay safe out there. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video.